You be
Welcome to the last event of the Slovak leg of these Universiade, and it's the fifth ski jumping event, and it's the only one really so far not dominated by Russia. And today we have 10 teams going in this men's competition. Norway, Czech Republic, Ukraine, Germany, Finland, Slovenia, Japan, Austria, Russia and Poland. Russia, the big favourites, with Hazetdinov looking for a second medal. But look out for Japan too, with Junshiro Kobayashi looking for a second gold. He got a mixed team gold. Stop. To Takanashi, looking to give Japan a good start, and that's just over the 90 metres. That's a good jump from the Japanese. Minato Mabuchi. To 87 and 88.5 metres in the individual. Can he go towards 90? It was just short. It's good effort, though. Probably just a metre or two short of 90. There's the third Japanese jumper going. Junshiro Kobayashi's had a really good tournament, and he's continuing it there. So the favourites are Russia. Is Klimov. How far can he go? He's got a lot of potential, and that's a monster jump from Evgeniy Klimov. Well, that's at least 96 metres. Mikhail Maximochkin, disappointed that he didn't do better in the individual. Multiple Universiade medalist, looking for 90, and I think he's just about got 90 there. Keeps Russia in a good position. Ilmir Hazetdinov. Such a great potential. Olympic Games competitor, and that was pretty good as well. Coached by Ramel Abramov. Poland, now they're the defending champions in this competition, 2 years ago winning gold. Andrzej Zapotoczny for Poland. Yeah, he's made his 90 quite comfortably. That's a good jump from him. Jakub Kot. He's going down as the best Polish jumper today. Jakub Kot came 15th in the individual. Two jumps just a little bit under 90. It's considerably short though, 85 metres. Well, let's see what that means after the first half of this competition, after the third round. Russia are leading. But, you know, the gap is only 5.1 points. So there are a lot of work to do. Poland 24.4 behind the leaders, and Germany in with a shout as well. Florian Menz going for Germany. They'd need to do something really special to get a bronze. Certainly at least look to get fourth. And, yeah, that's a good jump from Menz, you know. It's a little bit short of 90. Kanta Takanashi. Second half of the competition getting underway. Japan looking to chase Russia down and perhaps get the gold. Evgeniy Klimov, a superb jump, 96.5 metres, and looking to do better. That's a big ask, but he's going and going. That's a brilliant jump. Klimov has got, that's nearly 100 metres, 98 metres. There's Andrzej Zapotoczny, 95 metres for him. Fifth of six jumpers, Jan Mejlander. Germany really just looking to defend their fourth place for the moment. is that Minato Mabuchi needs something special, needs to go well over 90 if they've got any chance of getting a gold. Well, it's decent, but I don't think it'll be enough. Mikhail Maksimochkin. The Russians just need to be sensible now. Some solid jumps over the 90 and the gold should be theirs. That's exactly what Maksimochkin's done. Stanislaw Biela going for Poland. Maybe they can catch the Japanese. If there's going to be a change in the top three, that'll be it. Biela needs well over 90. 93.5. Tobias Seaman. Germany now, no chance realistically of getting a medal. Should be good enough for fourth though. Junshiro Kobayashi, he needs a huge jump really. And well, that's very impressive. Probably won't be enough to get a gold. Cot, it's around the 90. And that's going to be enough for Russia. Ilmir Hazetdinov is coming now. Jakub Kot then, well, that jump, not quite enough. And Russia have quite comfortably won the gold by 20.9 points. Japan have to be content with the silver, with Poland getting the bronze, 42.9 behind Russia. It's a third gold medal in the ski jumping for the Russians.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.